now have our sights set on the Elite Eight.
We certainly do. And standing in our way is International Falls, Minnesota. The Weather Channel's version of March Madness wants to determine which city has the toughest weather in America. If we win in this bracket, we then move on to take on the winner of Chicago and the Twin Cities. Just like March Madness, we're down to the Final Four in the toughest weather city tournament.
Fargo is still in the running for the Weather Channel's competition. We're taking on Juneau, Alaska now in what's being dubbed the Clash of the Cold. If we beat them, we take on either Bradford, Pennsylvania or New Orleans, Louisiana. I had my doubts with Juneau, Alaska, but once again, Fargo wins. We are on to the finals of the toughest weather city tournament.
Again, Fargo didn't just win, it dominated, punching its ticket to the Weather Channel's championship against someplace called Bradford, Pennsylvania. Voting for the matchup is underway as we speak.
Well, guys, we've had 847,000 votes, and the winner is the Fargo Express. Fargo, North Dakota is our America's toughest weather city champion. They came on strong in our opening day of voting, but then, boy, last night, Bradford, PA made a huge surge. But in the end, it was Fargo winning with about 54% of the vote, Bradford 46% of the vote, so a total of 55,000 votes in the final round. So congratulations to Fargo.
All right, thanks for that. And one of our meteorologists was covering a spring snowstorm last week in Fargo and knew that the win was coming.
Congratulations, Fargo. You've been voted America's toughest weather city. No surprise, you've got blizzards, minus 50 wind chills in the winter, in the summertime, 100 degree heat, mosquitoes, and in the springtime, it's the annual flood down on the Red River. And every year, everybody turns out to fill up millions of sandbags. And in the springtime, this is what it looks like in Fargo. Mountains of snow and temperatures around 20. Once again, way to go, Fargo. You are America's toughest weather city.
What is Seidel not climbing a snowbank?
I know, it's like his thing, he loves it.
Well, he's out in another spring snowstorm this morning. No snowbanks out there, but Mike, who do you think you would win between North Adams and Fargo?
Fargo wins! I caught him last week in Fargo. I knew they were gonna win!
Woo-hoo! Yes! Look at him go!
Yes! I'm going to Fargo! I'm going to Fargo! Oh God, it's great! Oh
Mike,
God.
You're supposed to go to Disney, not Fargo!
You know what?
So, how tough do you have to be to endure the elements in the nation's toughest weather city?
See, this is North Dakota. 32 degrees and no cold.
As tough as my grandma. Kristen Helgeson, Valley News Live.
Come on down here.
I like the change in seasons too, but I wish summer were longer and winter were
yes.
short. Anyway, well, Mayor Dennis Wallacker says he might exchange celebratory gifts with the mayor of Bradford, who we beat out.
Yeah, Bradford, Pennsylvania. Wallacker suspects that he'll get a Zippo lighter since they're made in Bradford, and he might send those chocolate-covered potato chips known as chippers to Pennsylvania.
That would be a good thing to send.
Fair enough.
Mike and Robin, well, this is just a beautiful neighborhood down here in South Fargo, but something you might not be used to seeing, well, these big yellow porta potties that are popping up and down the streets here, the sign that massive amounts of people are going to be coming in to help get us ready for this big flood.
Take a look at a couple of highlights here with regards to the flood. Any additional moisture in the basins, not a good thing for our flood forecast. Snow is better than rain the way it is right now, because rain causes a rapid melt. Even if we get a half inch of rainfall, it could quickly cause the rivers to rise. This storm will possibly bring some rain to portions of the valley.
Meantime, the red in Fargo is creeping up at 19 feet as of right now. The FM area hit flood stage on Tuesday. Fargo Mayor Dennis Wallacher tells Valley News Live that Fargo's evacuation plan will be released next week. The mayor says certain portions of the plan relating to homeland security will likely be omitted from the plan that is set to be released to the public. The city has been criticized by some, including the Forum newspaper, about the city's failure to release the information sooner. Wallacher says there are some people in this city who would like to see us fail.
A day after Fargo announced it would delay sandbag delivery indefinitely, it's been rescheduled. Mayor Wallacher says the deployment will begin Tuesday. Moorhead is also delaying sandbag deliveries. Mayor Mark Boxland says they are hoping for next week sometime as well. Mayor Boxland says Moorhead is in a watch and wait stage as people wait for flooding. But he says the city's diking system is as ready as it needs to be. All six of Moorhead's primary clay levee projects have been finished.